initiative down there. There's a drive-in cinema, if anyone's not been. And there's also a project within the terminal building itself to encourage a number of restaurants, sort of food outlets, to become a sort of a mini Baltic market type issue. So there are things happening already that we need to be informed of. So I've got a form of ways that I would like to sort of put forward to agree with noting the report, but sort of takes it on to another level. Is it worth me reading that out now?
Yeah.
It simply says the report be noted and officers be requested to report back on a three terminal strategy. This would not only inform short and long term capital implications and funded sources, it would also encourage a mutually beneficial dialogue with Whittle NBC and its newly formed Whittle Growth Company and other interested partners. And I would hope that that would put what we did wish for a couple of years back on track, and people would do that. So I think it's inclusive. Does need a, you know, the Woodside offer isn't there, it's not a destination in its own right yet, but there are plans for it to be so. Well, I'd like to keep on board with on the pump, keep on board with the strategy, the three-term strategy, and I hope members would be able to support that. We can always make decisions about funding as and when. It does even say about Seacon Ferry for as funding becomes available, doesn't become available. So there is slippage in the capital programme. You may want to think about in the long term putting a small reserve together if we need some money to put some of the terminals in a better state, whatever their future is. So I'm just asking for a more inclusive and more progressive approach. Thank you. So I'll move that. If that's agreed.
Yeah, is that
agreed? Is it possible to get a written copy?
Well, I was written right as I was thinking about it. So I've got to have
we've just thought about it.
Just read it again, Steve, and then it can be captured accordingly.
This report be noted, and officers be requested to report back. This report be noted, and officers be requested to report back on a three terminal strategy. This will not only inform short and long term capital implications and funding sources, but it would also encourage mutually beneficial dialogue with Whittle Borough Council, its newly formed Whittle Growth Company, and other interested partners. And so move that, if that's okay.
Okay, are we comfortable with that? Jerry, you seconded that?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. We have to accept that?
Yeah.
John Hotel.
Chair, just one quick point. It'll be easier for the recording if that is actually physically happening over there, so they get it verbatim as opposed to some sort of cobbled version.
We can pass that across and make sure it's captured.
This resolution, what I just
wrote. Is there any further question or comments anyone wants to raise on this report? Jerry?
Yeah, just, again, I just wanted to see back what Steve said, and just particularly Merseyside tourism is going to continually expand. It's continually expanding. There's no question that Woodside is an essential site for developers from a heritage standpoint. And we very much really need to look at that site. It's got so much history there, from you know, the Monks Ferry to Lairds to the whole elements of the area. It's just, you know, it has an international standard to start. What I would so the three terminal strategy is an absolute, it's something we have to ask that question. Can I also go back, as ever, as I'm always talking about heritage, but just to thank the officers for the relations of that event with Jack Potter last year. A couple of people, a number of people, were lost in there, and what they were about the event, so I'll just briefly. Minutes about it. Jack Potter was a policy basically a Swift Fire pilot, and he's in the Dunkirk film, and the people in the Dunkirk film are mentioned by name but by actions. And so he was educated, he was born in Boston, educated at Yorkshire School. His father was the Commodore later, he was shot down into the channel again. This time, he was picked up by the German air rescue and the and so he died about 20 years ago. The family all came right across the globe to work with a special group erected by the entrance of the docks. And we arranged for the ferries to come along and to transform. And the whole event was just spectacularly done. And again, it was an international, national, international coverage of that event. And we just wanted to thank the officers and everyone who was involved. And again, that's another, just to highlight how important heritage is.
Further questions or comments? Chris, sorry.
Next year. Just showing the ignorance a little bit as a new member. So, from what I gather, we've still got the three sort of old ferries. Royal Defford is out of service, and obviously that in 312 is the one that we're looking at the future of. It mentions about there currently being no viable option and we're currently waiting for expressions of interest. Presumably that's kind of focused on the tourism and heritage aspect of the ferries. And whilst there might not be a viable option as a working ferry, presumably we're looking to explore the options of maybe it's a static display, use it as a space for cafes and coffee shops, things like that. Presumably that's where we're up to.
That's exactly right. We wouldn't limit its viable options to just being an operating vessel. There's been discussions with potential, for example, lifetime museums, home museums, here for display. There's been potential uses, cafes and drop-in centres, and there is potential uses, training facilities too. Each one of those we've not been able to develop a viable option really. And it's largely based on the cost needed to operate a vessel of that nature.
So.
Thanks, yeah. Thanks, Gary. Gary, what did Manchester Ship Canal do? Last year there was some issues out of your control with regards to the locks. Sound a bit gimmicky, but when over a million people voted for Baltimore Boldface, the loyal Baltimore Boldface may actually work as to get people on the ferries.
Okay, so if we're dealing with the easy one first, the Manchester Ship Canal Cruises can be recently, as well as a number of further events on the canal, where you have delays due to the bridge not opening, the locks being stuck, and so on. The current arrangements are twofold. There are customers, so any compensation offered, or any, generally it's a retrip offered, so a return visit offered, that would be met by ourselves. But there's a book that there is an arrangement in operation with the Manchester Ship Canal Company, which sees if we are delayed for any period or extended period of time, that reduces the cost of the tolls associated with that trip. So in effect, the ferries would be no worse off with the potential reputational damage. And in recognition of that, that's one of the main reasons why we're developing the programme that you've see for the summer evenings, if we're operating on the river, is far less complex than what we're going to do. So there's kind of a strategic concept of that. In terms of procurement, it's my understanding, and I'm happy to be corrected by the colleague at the front, is that the procurement will be subject to the Public Contract Regulations 2015, which are driven from EU directives, which mean we're not able to stipulate something as simple as British. Okay, it will be an open European tender process that we cannot specify in that nature. Am I right in that or is that? So I haven't listened to the advice of the officials that we are going to get into that place. And sorry, the last one was.
It may sound a bit gimmicky, but loyal both face.
So I think that the drivers of the plan has always been behind the scenes, that we'll have at some stage, subject to funding and all relevant approvals, of course, there will be two vessels operating in the river, there will be two new Mersey ferries, and they'll be traditionally named Royal Daffodil and Royal Irish of the Mersey. So we'll be retaining the royal names and status and a heritage associated with them rather than running a competition for new names.
Well, you're free to use your own messages.
I do not want to read in the Echo tomorrow. I do not want to read in the Echo tomorrow. New ferry to be called Boating Boat.
That's how
we
get publicity.
No, I think it's very clear, seriously, that we will be retaining the traditional names because they are part of the sort of heritage and the sort of genuinely cherished nature of the ferries on the River Moses. Just avoidance of any doubt around that. Yeah, any further questions or comments? Francis.
Can I just say that we were going on the ferries and we were offered another date on those ferries. So we can say so.
There we go, thanks. Can we then agree the recommendations in paragraph 2 with the addition of Steve's wording accordingly, if that's agreed? Excellent. Item 6 then, and we're nearly there folks, is the quarter 4 corporate plan performance and financial monitoring report for the back end of 2017-18, and I think it's Stephen setting this question.
Hi, thank you Chair. I'll be quick on this one because performance for the kind of outturn of 17-18 was looking pretty good, as you can see from the statistics that are in the report. Just for new members, I'll make this quick because it's been a long session. Just to point out, we kind of used two elements to the report for performance. It was something we took some priorities and activities that people have been undertaking. We also look at some data that we collect to kind of that hopefully will basically crack into.
Hang on.
I think we're going to have to use the kit. Is it the individual microphone that's the problem?
Yeah,
cracked it all.
It is probably the microphone that asset management are looking at. So
we can't try to push it through the microphones because obviously we've got people hearing it there.
So
turn to page 26, that is the overall summary of the activity. So as I say, we've got the KPIs to look in good fashion. There are a couple around rail and bus, but we don't have the data available yet. We do have the data, it's just been an internal system error where we need to get that data accurate and present that at the next quarter report today. As on 26, you can see the traction of 36 level activities. In the green and the amber green, you've got 93.7%, you've got 94% more or less activities on course. They match with the KPIs that are all going in the right direction. So as a turn report from the activity shows that we are achieving the reasons that those struggle to be here. The activities are obviously correct and we've delivered the KPIs across the right direction. There's no concerns really from that. Obviously some turn up as red and we use an aggregate system that looks at how people are developing and delivering their activities daily across the organisation, and then we overall rate them as a red and a green. So within each of the pages under each priority, you will see where there are activities that have become red or red amber, and we explain the reasons for them. So hopefully that will give you a good answer as to what the issues are and what has been corrected. If you have any further questions, there are officers in the room that might be able to answer, or kind of come back to you with those. So overall, just to make it quick before I pass the job to the finance, activities are looking good, they're being delivered, KPIs are going in the right direction. We've got the 2018-19 corporate plan, which we're delivering now, implemented in Q1. It should be either in your post boxes or on its way to you now. It's also on the website, so you can see that for next year, 18-19, we are tracking a certain number of activities, which are on the page 12 and 13. You'll be getting reports against this as of next month.
Well, given that we've got some comms issues, the outturn is in the report from page 37 onwards. The revenue outturn is impacted significantly by the rolling stock project last year, rolling stock activity. The reduction in special rail grant and our activities on bus services, in particular the use of supported bus network, and on the other side a really strong financial performance by Digital Story, which enabled the organisation to take a dividend from the Digital Story, which has helped out with the cost of operating the Mersey ferries last year. The capital outturn is well, given that the capital programme last year was such a scale, to have delivered what is £84 million worth of £93 million capital programme, I think it's quite a significant achievement by all those involved. Those major programmes that have slipped have tended to be a factory network rail schemes that at Newton Willows, Bull North, which is happily now open, and the Holt Curve, which were beyond the direct control of the organisation and officers, but certainly within our influence, and are obviously picked up this year. I think, other than that, I'm just happy to answer any questions on the financial reports rather than trying to pick anything else out.
Any questions or comments? Steve, and then
yeah, obviously. You know, we have to remember the history, particularly for new members, and we've had 3 years of cuts to our levy, and that's helped all the local authorities in the city region with their budget problems under austerity, so we've had to play our part in that. This year it's a frozen levy, which presents an equally challenging, given inflation and all the other things that are going on. But clearly, I'm always pleased as lead member for finance that we've come in with a £2 million underspend. That's always better than a £2 million overspend, I've always been taught. And it looks on the indicators in terms of performance that we are maintaining performance with less money to do it with. So, but overall, I think it's a positive report, and I'd just like to congratulate everyone within finance and performance and all the obviously individual officers who contributed. That's been another outstanding outturn for that year. But the challenges you made, our budget is subsidised by reserves. It we will be looking for savings, and some of those savings are getting less and less palatable, so members just need to all wait.